Like an array, a tuple is another example of a primitive compound type in Rust. Also like an array, the length of the tuple is immutable. But unlike an array, the elements of a tuple can be of different data types. As a side note, this compound type can be pronounced either tuple or tuple. I'm going to be referring to it as a tuple. With that said, let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code, where I've already created a new .rs file. I've also written the boilerplate code for the main function. To construct a tuple, use a pair of parentheses, as opposed to a pair of square brackets. You can ignore this warning message since we're going to mutate this tuple in a few minutes. The output is displayed after the warning message. So this is an example of a mutable tuple with three elements of type string literal, i32, and string literal. To access an element in a tuple, use the variable name followed by a dot, and then the index number. Like with an array and a vector, indexing a tuple is zero-based. So in this example, the first element is index 0. Again, you can ignore this warning message and go straight to the output below. If you declare the variable as a mutable variable, then you can mutate the value of any element in the tuple, as long as the new value is the same data type as the initial value of that element. Now that you've mutated the tuple, the warning message goes away. Although the tuple elements are mutable, the tuple length is immutable, so you can't add new elements to a tuple. Now here's something interesting that you can do with a tuple. In the coding world, this is called a destructuring assignment. So rather than having a single variable name on the left-hand side of the assignment operator, this example has a tuple, which contains three new variable names as elements of that tuple. On the right-hand side is an existing variable name, which also happens to be a tuple, that contains three elements with existing values. Using the syntax, we'll assign the first element in the tuple on the right-hand side to the variable name in the first element in the tuple on the left-hand side, and so on. By doing this, You can now refer to the values in the original tuple by variable names, as opposed to using index numbers. Pretty cool, right? So that's the basics of using tuples in Rust. In the next chapter, you'll learn what a hash map is and how to use it in Rust.